in Gaza, when you have over almost 2 million people, they are living on 139 square miles. You have 1.3 million of the people in Gaza, they are refugees.
That's right.
They are, their villages, actually, some of their villages, not that far from Gaza Strip, actually. All of this siege for almost 11 years, living in refuge, in refugee camps for 70 years, attacks, wars, people dying, children dying. It's the issue for us is to return back to our villages. This is how we can feel settled. This is how we can feel secure. This is how we can make a good future for our new generations. It's not for us just, it's for the new generation. People in Gaza, they are trying, I say, the people, the simple people, like women, men, youth, they try to take their own initiatives and they try to access their rights. They want to go back. They want to end the suffering by accessing their right to go back to live in their villages. And by the way, most of the Palestinian villages inside Israel, it's empty. It's just not, like my mother village, it's like a national park. Mm-hmm. Nature reserve, actually. Reservation, they say it. Nature, just for the Israelis.
You know, the statistics are that more than 90% of the depopulated villages, Palestinian villages, are still empty.
Yeah, and people, they can go back. But because we are Palestinian and we look like this, our blood, we are Arabs, we are not Jewish, we are not allowed to access this right. But anyone is Jewish anywhere in the world, from South Africa or from Sweden or from Australia,
or
anytime.
From Brooklyn.
Or from Brooklyn or from Berkeley and San Francisco. Anytime you want to go back to live there, yeah, you can claim that you are Jewish and go live there. Because you are Jewish, you can live there. People there, the indigenous people, they are not allowed to live there.